Welcome back to Proactive London, where I'm joined by Clarissa Sowemimo-Coker and Dr. Tim Korn, who are the CEO and CMO, respectively, at Oxford Cannabinoid Technologies. So firstly, great to have you both on the line, and I'm going to jump straight in with a question for you, Clarissa. We had an RNS from you last week all about Dr. Tim. Perhaps you can tell us a bit about what you announced.
Yeah, sure. Happy to. So last week, we were very pleased to announce that Tim has joined our board of directors formally, effective immediately last week. Tim, of course, joined us as Chief Medical Officer back in June, and we announced that. And I think you and I, in fact, spoke about it, Tom, back earlier in the year. But this is sort of the next step in the progression, of course, as we had the successful phase one single ascending dose results that we announced very recently in October. I'm delighted to say that, you know, Tim stepped into a board position with the company, which gives the board, of course, and our exec colleagues a lot of comfort that we've got a clinician, you know, a proper medic on the board for OCT.
Fantastic. Thank you very much, Clarissa. So let's hear from the man himself now, Tim. Firstly, a very warm welcome to Proactive. And yeah, it's great to have you on. Perhaps you could tell us what it was that you were attracted to at OCT to get us started.
Right. Well, I've been, the greater part of my career has been spent in drug development. And throughout that time, I've really been sort of drawn to situations where there's unmet medical need and clearly identified reasons for being in the field. And when there's some novelty in the therapeutic approach, and OCTs seem to combine both of those things for me. Both of the conditions that we're addressing in our two programs are important and unmet, both treated currently with old drugs that tend to have not very good side effects and rather poor efficacy. So there's a clear need there. And the cannabinoid approach to medicines really needs to be optimized. And I think OCT's strategies there are right on the money.
That's all very clear. Thank you, Tim. So you are obviously Chief Medical Officer. You're on the board now. So where is your focus day to day?
Well, I think there are two aspects now to my job. The first is the Chief Medical Officer aspect, and that remains the same. My job there is to make sure that the clinical programs are done as efficiently as possible and to address what the regulatory authorities will require of us to give us a regulatory approval. And that means designing clinical studies with the regulators in mind, as well as the patients, and consulting with regulators. I've always found them very helpful, actually, despite what some people say about them, when it comes to designing programs that will ultimately lead to product approval. So that's the first part, and that remains the same. With regard to the board, I've always taken the view that when a company is in clinical development, actually treating patients, it's not a bad idea to have a physician on the board, if only to make sure that the board is taking the patient's interest as seriously as it takes the financial interest of the company. So we have to do both. We have to be doing our best for the patients, making sure they're safe first and foremost, but making sure that we address what they need and making sure the board understands that too. I've also had a fair amount of experience of board work, so I can do the fiduciary part of it as well. I hope to be able to bring both of those aspects of my experience to the board.
Thank you very much indeed, Tim. Let's turn back to you now, Clarissa. Talk to us a bit about the cash runway.
Sure. Yeah. So I think it's very well known that we've got cash runway all the way through to April next year. That's obviously coming along. It will be here before we probably expect it. Of course, you will be expecting that the board and the rest of my colleagues are working hard behind the scenes to look at different ways of funding the business as we go forward. And there are lots of options on the table at the moment. I can't say too much about those, Tom, of course, but I'm hoping to be back with you quite soon to give you an update on that. But rest assured, we're all pretty confident that we are doing all the right things in that regard.
I understand, obviously, you are a little bit constrained in that regard, but do you think we'll hear from you this side of Christmas, Clarissa?
Potentially, Tom. I don't want to be led too much on that one. As soon as I have anything to share, you will be one of the first to know.
All right. I look forward to it. Thank you both very much indeed for your time. And we'll catch you again very soon, I hope.
Thank you.
Thank you.